Hi, this is Asghar Ghori again, and I'll show you how to create a file system in a Linux disk partition in this video. For demonstration, I'll use my CentOS 7 system. However, the commands I'll use work pretty much the same on other popular Linux distributions and their derivatives as well. Also, for this video, I have already allocated a 500 megabyte disk to my Linux system. The procedure presented here applies equally to both physical and virtual Linux systems. I discussed disk partitioning using the partit command in my other video titled How to Create and Delete a Disk Partition in Linux using the partit program. I also used the lsvlk command in that video to list available storage devices, their sizes, and partition status. I will be reusing both commands for disk identification and partition creation in the next few minutes. In addition, I'll be using a few other commands. The mkfs command, for example, is to create a file system in a disk partition. The mount command to make a file system accessible to users. The df command to view file system sizes and their mount status. And I'm also going to be using the umount command to make a file system inaccessible. As part of the procedure, I'll also show you how to edit the fstab file and add an entry for a new file system in that file so that the file system is automatically remounted when the system is rebooted. Let's get it started. Let's first identify the 500 MB disk that is available for us to work with. LSBLK, list block devices. And here's the disk. SDB is the name of the disk, 500 megabytes in size, and it is available for us to use. Assuming that this is a brand new disk, let's apply the label MS-DOS to it with the partit program. Sudo partit /dev/sdb, which is the device file for the disk. And then we use the mklabel command and specify the MS-DOS partition table type. Enter. It says the existing disk label on SDB will be destroyed and all data on the disk will be lost. Do you want to continue? Yes, sure. And we can verify with the print subcommand. MS-DOS partition table type, 537 megabytes in size, /dev/sdb is the disk. Now let's create our first partition. Sudo partit /dev/sdb/mkpart. Primary partition type is starting at 1 megabyte, and we want to end this partition at 251 megabytes. So we want to create a 250 megabyte partition on this disk. And there you go, it is all done. Let's use the print subcommand again. And the summary of the partition table shows us that a new partition is created. Partition number one is starting at 1 megabyte, ending at 251. And the size of the primary partition is 250 megabytes. The next step is to use the mkfs command to create file system structures on this partition. So we use the mkfs command. We specify a file system type with the -t option. For this demonstration, we use the ext4 file system type. And then we specify the path name to the first partition on the SDB disk, /dev/sdb1. This is the utility that was executed in the background. OS type is Linux, block size is 1 megabyte, fragment size 1 megabyte, and other information for the file system. The file system is created successfully. Now let's try to make this file system accessible to us. So in order to do that, we need to mount this file system. Let's create a directory called test par to mount this file system on. Directory is created, and then we use the mount command to mount this file system. We specify the file system device file first, sdb1, and then the mount point, test par. We verify with the df command. The output indicates that there is a file system in the sdb1 partition, 227 megabytes in size, 2.1 megabytes in use, 209 megabytes are available, 1% is used, and the mount point is /taskbar. Now we can cd into taskbar and create files in it. The next I want to show you is how to unmount this file system manually. So we use the umount command, and we can specify either the file system device file or the mount point of it. So let's use the mount point. We run the df command again, and this time you don't see the file system in the output. Now let's modify the fstab file and make sure that when the system is rebooted, the file system gets automatically mounted. Go to the bottom, press the letter O to open a new line. /dev/sdb1 is the file system device file name. Then taskbar is the mount point name. The type of the file system is ext4. And we want to use all the defaults with the mount command, 0 and 0. We don't want to perform any checks on this file system. Save the file and exit out of the VI editor. Now we can simply run the mount command with the minus A option to mount all the file systems that are listed in the fstab file but are not currently mounted. No error messages, and we can verify with the df command. Right here, same entry. Now at this point, if I reboot my system, this file system will be automatically mounted. And that's all for the procedure. And this brings us to the conclusion of this video. Try the file system creation procedure on your Linux systems. I suggest to perform the procedure on CentOS, Ubuntu, and OpenSUSE Linux. Don't forget to check out the manual pages of the commands that we've used in this video for additional information. And here is a list of all the free videos on Linux that I've created for you. These videos complement my books on Linux to understand Linux from scratch to an advanced level, and at the same time help you get ready for Linux certification exams such as RHCSA, RHCE, CompTIA Linux Plus, LPIC1, Linux Foundation, LFCS, and LFCE. If you like this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up, provide your comments below, and share it with your friends and colleagues. Please subscribe to my channel to be among the first to get notifications of my new upcoming videos. Thank you for your time.